it's quite shocking to say that there's really a very pressing unmet medical need and challenges in the mental health spaces associated with opioid use disorder. Now, the OUD affects approximately 16 million people globally. That's greater than 120,000 opioid-associated deaths annually. And there just needs to be a better way.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is ATAI Life Sciences Chief Scientific Officer, Glenn Short. Glenn, very good to speak with you, and congratulations on the NIH grant. How does receiving this grant validate ATAI's discovery program?
Thank you so much, Stephen. I really appreciate the opportunity to chat with you today. Just to let the audience know, the NIH grant process, of course, is a highly competitive review process. And the process is made up of independent scientific grant reviewers that have expertise in opioid use disorder or OUD. It's overall pharmacology and drug development. And so this was really the first time that external parties were able to get a so-called look under the hood, if you will, at the ATAI discovery story, which is really focused on the serotonergic 2A and 2C agonists that we discovered have non-hallucinogenic potential. And overall, the reviewers thought that this polypharmacy approach using the 2A and 2C agonist targeting in OUD could have a significant impact, that our overall scientific approach was innovative, and that we would serve as a good development partner for the National Institute on Drug Abuse as these agonists progress through development. So I think that overall the process, this review process, validated the novelty of our approach, the utility of the 2A2C agonist with non-hallucinogenic potential in OUD, and the promise of our current lead compounds.
Glenn, many people are familiar with ATAI's psychedelic-based therapies. How's the discovery program different? Can you provide background on the discovery program, especially since this program focuses on non-hallucinogenic compounds as well as AI?
Yeah, this is a really interesting story, Stephen. It all started back in 2019 with our desire to actually come up with novel psychedelic or compounds that maintained a hallucinogenic potential, but albeit had a shorter duration of effect in relation to typical psychedelics. So what we embarked upon was to emulate or mimic the pharmacology, the desirable pharmacology of psychedelics, but then dial out the undesirable pharmacology of psychedelics. And so we started a collaboration with a company at the time called Cyclica out of Toronto, Canada, and they are now have been purchased by Recursion. And the unique thing about Cyclica's technology was that you could scan the entire proteome for your specific drug and understand your drug's interactions with various proteomic targets. And so this was a very powerful AI-based, machine learning-based approach. So we were able to leverage this to be able to, in silico, identify compounds that had the target polypharmacology that we wanted, namely the 2A and the 2C agonism, but then dialed out undesirable pharmacologies, such as those associated with 5-HT2B, which chronic activation leads to cardiac valvulopathy, which we want to avoid. Engagement of dopamine receptors, which we wanted to avoid, or histamine receptors, for example. And that was the starting place. We actually made these molecules that were identified by AI. We were able to then test them, and we found that a handful of these molecules actually had the polypharmacology that we wanted. And If you asked me at the very beginning if we were going to be successful leveraging AI in this way, I was rather dubious. So it was quite a discovery. But based upon this, we then embarked upon a traditional medicinal chemistry campaign, in which we then were able to optimize compounds. And during this process, we discovered that a subset of these molecules did not appear to have hallucinogenic-like properties similar to psychedelics when we were testing them in animal models, such as the mouse head twitch response, and later on in drug discrimination assays and rats trained to recognize psilocybin. They did not give responses that these molecules were similar to psilocybin. So this is sort of the input into the grant where these molecules, these 5-HT2A2C agonists with non-hallucinogenic potential, will be the starting point. We have two molecular classes right now that serve as our leads going into the grant.
Glenn, what does this NIH grant mean for ATAI and the work you're doing in mental health?
Yeah, I mean, first off, very simply, it's really a source of non-dilutive funding. It's milestone funding based. So it's really going to keep us disciplined and focused in OUD. But importantly, the program that I was just mentioning, the discovery process, it was really initially tuned, for the depression space. And so this allows us an opportunity to expand our capabilities and focus beyond depression into OUD as a second indication. And I think that, additionally, this is going to accelerate our overall lead optimization process in OUD. Like I mentioned, it provides a ready source of funding to advance these development candidates later on into IND enabling activities that are involving preclinical testing as well as CMC-based activities.
Why is it so important to find new treatments for OUD, and how could your approach make a difference?
Yeah, I mean, this is really, it's quite shocking to say that there's really a very pressing unmet medical need and challenges in the mental health spaces associated with opioid use disorder. I mean, OUD affects approximately 16 million people globally. That's greater than 120,000 opioid-associated deaths annually. And there just needs to be a better way. Current therapies, methadone, buprenorphine, naltrexone, for example, I mean, they're effective, but they're limited. They're targeting the mu opioid receptor itself to essentially block any opioid binding to the receptor. But here our approach is different. So by identifying hopefully compounds that are driving 2A and 2C agonism, we can find compounds that reduce craving and potentially relapse via activation of these serotonergic pathways. So, traditional OUD treatments do not adequately address the multiple dimensions of addiction. So, namely, underlying trauma that's associated with driving the substance abuse itself as a coping mechanism, or the compulsive drug-seeking behavior. That are caused by dysregulated reward circuitry in the brain. Our agonists have an ability to potentially engage multiple dimensions to be able to target both of these sorts of dimensions in addiction. Namely, on the 5-HT2A activation side, this is known to help drive trauma processing, memory consolidation, and very importantly, neuroplasticity, such that you are actually attenuating the neural circuitry in the brain and hopefully allowing a dysregulated neural network to become more normative and regulated appropriately. The second thing is on the 2C activation. So 2C is normally involved in modulating the mesolimbic dopamine levels. And of course, this is very intertwined with drug seeking, for example. So we hope that these drugs will have the potential to also curb drug seeking behaviors and ultimately prevent time to relapse.
Maybe just finally, Glenn, how do public-private partnerships like this one with the NIH help move science forward faster?
Right. I think it's really these public-private partnerships are really a force multiplier, if you will, in translational science. And you know, the thing about this UG3, UH3 grant is that it's really a partnership with the NIH. It's a partnership with the National Institute on Drug Abuse. And so we have access to the Institute's expertise in OUD. And that's not to say that the ATAI team doesn't have OUD expertise. We actually do. But I think that the overall combination of our drug discovery and the NIDA Scientific Brain Trust will ultimately allow this program to move much faster and smarter.
Well, Glenn, I hope you'll keep us updated on progress with that partnership. Thank you very much for taking the time today.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Glenn Short is CSO at ATAI Life Sciences.